Good morning, Mandan. Let us have a brief recap of what we had done in the last class. Suppose if we consider analog signal, analog sinusoidal signal, XRT equals to cos omega t. Do you think this is periodic? Yeah, you should answer. Is it periodic? Here omega is some constant and belongs to R. Okay, you can answer. Is it periodic? X of t equals to cos omega t. That's a continuous time signal. You can respond. Is it periodic? This is periodic, right? X of t equals to cos omega t. It's a periodic. You can have a look into this one. The period of this one is 2 pi by omega. X of t equals to cos omega t. Periodic means that should satisfy this condition, right? This is omega. It should satisfy this condition. X of t plus t should be equals to x of t. This should be satisfied for periodicity. And if I substitute this one, this is possible only when omega t equals to 2 pi k, where k is integer. It means t equals to 2 pi by omega. It's a fundamental period of this analog signal cos omega t. It means cos omega t is always periodic. This is always periodic. And the period of that one is 2 pi by omega, where omega is some constant, some real constant. This is always true, always periodic for continuous time case. And the time period of this one will decrease as the frequency increases, because t equals to 2 pi by omega, right? If I try to increase omega, t will decrease, right? Because t equals to 2 pi by omega. As I increase omega analog frequency, the time period, the fundamental period keeps on decreasing. It's inverse, right? It's all the time this is true for analog case or continuous time case. But when coming to discrete time signals, we have seen some strange thing, right? Let me consider discrete time sinusoidal signals. These are discrete time sinusoidal signals. Cos omega naught n, sin omega naught n, e power j omega naught n, or e power minus j omega naught n, where n belongs to z, integer. This need not be periodic all the time. We have seen in the last class, right? This discrete time sinusoidal signal need not be periodic all the time, like that continuous time. Continuous time is always periodic, but this need not be periodic. And it's also verified that if I increase my omega, small omega in this case, my period, that fundamental period, need not be decreased. That need not be decreasing one if I increase my omega. This need not be true all the time for digital case. We have seen these examples in the last class. For example, x of n equals to cos pi by 4 n. In this case, fundamental period is 8. We have proved that n1 equal to 8. This is periodic with a period of 8, fundamental period. And cos 3 pi by 8 into n. This is periodic with a period of 16. When it says this, right, x of n plus n should be equal to x of n, where n should be some integer, right, positive integer. We'll try to look for smallest possible positive integer in such a manner that x of n plus n equals x of n for all small n. And we verified that n1 equal to 8, n2 equal to 16. And cos n is aperiodic. This is not a periodic signal. This is not periodic. We have proved this because we can't find any integer capital N. Due to pi is irrational, that we have seen in the last class. It means that cosine signal or sinusoidal signal need not be periodic when coming to digital. And we can have a look into this one. This frequency is omega 1 equal to 2 pi by 8. This can be written like 2 pi by 8. This is small compared to this one. This is bigger compared to this frequency. And period also bigger, right? You can have a look into this one. This period also bigger compared to this one. When coming to continuous case, if the frequency is bigger, time period should be small, right? But when coming to discrete case, this need not always. Sometimes, if the frequency is bigger, time period is small. Sometimes, if the frequency is bigger, time period also bigger. That need not satisfy, right? The proportionality when coming to digital. And we have seen this example also. We are adding two periodic signals, cos pi by 4n plus cos 3 pi by 8n. And the overall period of this signal is LCM of these two periods, right? This we have verified in the last class. LCM of these two things. Okay, I'll ask a question to you. What is the period of this one? Yeah, I should answer. Cos pi by 4n plus cos n. What is the period of this? Yes.
It's a periodic.
What is the period of this one? A periodic, right? Okay, you answered a periodic. Yes, it's a periodic. Because we know that this is a periodic, right? This is periodic with a period of 8. But this is a periodic. This is not a periodic signal at all. You can't find n in such a manner that x of n plus n equals to x of n. You can't find such things. This is a periodic signal. Yeah, this is a brief summary that we read from the last class, right? And let me try to summarize that once again. This is sinusoidal signal. A cos omega naught n plus pi, or A sin omega naught n plus pi, or A e power j omega naught n plus pi, or A e power minus j omega naught n plus pi. All of them are having same period. If they are periodic, all of these signals will have same fundamental period. When that is periodic, periodic, everyone is periodic. That's true for all the things. They are periodic only when omega naught equals to k1 pi by k2, where k1, k2 are some positive integers. This should be some rational number, or this should be some integer. This factor for pi. Omega naught equals to some pi into some rational number, or this can be some integer also, this factor. If this is true, then that is definitely periodic. Otherwise, that is not a periodic. Otherwise, that won't be periodic. As we have seen that x of n equal to cos n. N there is 1, right? We can't express 1, something like this, right? Some irrational number into some rational number. We can't express something like this. This should be satisfied. Then we can say that is a periodic signal. And when coming to continuous case, do you think different frequency signals will have same period? Is it possible for continuous case? Is it true or false? Or omega 2? These are two different frequencies. Do you think, is there any chance that T1 equal to T2? Is it true or false? For continuous case. You can have a look into this, right? T equal to 2 pi by omega. T1 equals to 2 pi by omega 1. They are equal only when omega 1 equal to omega 2. Otherwise, they are unequal. The T1 and T2 implies this one. If they are unequal, their periods are also unequal. That is true for continuous case. But for discrete case, that need not be true. Then coming to discrete case, we can have something like this. Let me have an example. Okay, just for your understanding, let me divide this 2 pi by n. Okay, let me consider that n equal to 8, for example, 2 pi by 8, and x2 of n equals to plus 2 pi, k equal to 2, 2 by 8. And x3 of n equals to 2 pi into 3 by 8. And so on, some x7 of n equals to cos 2 pi into 7 by 8. Okay, what is the period of this signal? What is the period of this signal? You can answer, right? We need to look for this, right? X of n plus n should be equal to x of n, where this should be integer. X1 now. Yeah. What is the period of cos 2 pi by 8? You can answer, right? What is the period of cos 2 pi by 8? If you want, you can type. That's also fine for me. It is okay, right? N1 equal to 8. This is a period of this one. What about N2? No, you can think and answer. You can think for a while and answer. We need to satisfy this condition, right? You can cross check that. N plus n should be equals to cos 2 pi into 2 by 8 into n. This should be satisfied. It's possible only when 2 by 8 into n equals 2 pi into some integer. That should be satisfied, right? And what should be n? Yeah, what should be n? N2 equal to 4, is it true? I'm claiming that n2 equal to 4. N2 equal to 4, that's. And period, when coming to period, any integer multiple of fundamental period also period, right? 8 also period for this, and 12 also period for this, and so on. Here, 8, 16, the other periods, 16. 24 and so on, the other periods. And what about this one? Third one. What is the period of this? N3 equal to 2 pi into 3 by 8. You can have a look into this. 2 pi into 3 by 8 into n plus n should be equals to cos 2 pi 3 by 8 into n. This is valid only when the second part, if I split this into two parts, with multiplication, the second part should be equal to 2 pi k. N equal to 2 pi k. 2 pi gets cancelled out, and n equal to 8 by 3 k. N equal to 8 by 3 k. But k equal to 3, this is an integer. for k equal to 3, this gets cancelled out. K equal to 1, 2, 3 and so on. For k equal to 3, this is the smallest possible integer we are going to get. 8, right? It means 8 is the fundamental period of this. 8 is the fundamental period. And the subsequent periods will be 8, 16, 24 and so on. Similarly, what the period of cos 2 pi into 4 by 8 into n? What is the period of this?
N 8.
8 is the period, that's fine. What is the fundamental period? Fundamental period.
2.
There is no doubt, this is a period. What is the fundamental period? I have to satisfy this condition, right? 2 pi into 4 by 8 into n should be 2 pi into some integer. Cancel out. 4 2s implies n equal to 2k. So k equal to 1, 2, 3 if I substitute this one. The smallest possible integer I am going to get is 2, right? 2 is the fundamental bit of this. 2, 4, 6, 8 and so on. These are also periods. Multiples of fundamental period. 8. 10 and so on. Then what about this cos 2 pi into 5 by 8 into n? What is the fundamental period of this?
Eight.
8, right? That's the fundamental period. 2 pi into 5 by 8 into n equal to 2 pi k. 2 pi gets cancelled out. 8 by 5 into k. N equal to 8k by 5, smallest possible integer I am going to get is for k equal to 5. 5 gets cancelled out, I will get 8. And the periods for this are 8, 16, 21. Now we can have a look into this. There is some mistake, right? Is there any mistake in the statement? I have some mistake in the statement. I said fundamental period. I said that cos 2 pi k by n into n for all k equal to 1 to n minus 1 will have fundamental period n. It's not true, right? They are having same period n, but they don't have same fundamental period. Need not be true, right? Because when you consider this case, let's have this. A small mistake I had in there. Can you have a look into this? For this period is 8, fundamental period. For k equal to 1 case. For k equal to 2 case, the fundamental period I got is 4. For k equal to 3, 8. And for k equal to 4, in this example, when n equal to 8. For k equal to 4, I got fundamental period 2, right? For k equal to 5, I got fundamental period 8. Like this I got, right? At least for everyone, the period is common, right? Forget about fundamental period. At least they are, all of them are having the same period. 8 is common for everyone, right? 8 is common for everyone. You can have a look into this. Even though fundamental period is 4, this period is common for everyone. At least one of them is having a fundamental period of n, right? In this case, n equal to 8. You see n. Yeah. In this case, capital N equal to 8. At least one of them is having a fundamental period of capital N, right? According to this one. And some of them might have fundamental period less than this also. But at least one of them is having a fundamental period of 8. And that fundamental period is common for all of them, all others. Like this young fundamental period 8. This might be having a period of 8. Need not be fundamental period. The common for everyone, right? From this we can conclude something. This is not fundamental period, it's a period. But at least one of them is having this fundamental period of n. We can conclude that cos 2 pi k by n into n for k equal to 1, 2 and so on up to n minus 1 will have same period n, that period n is common, and at least one of them will have a fundamental period of capital N. And based on this, we can conclude that What is the fundamental period of this summation? Yeah, I'll try to ask a question to you. Let me consider x of n equals to 2π/8 into n. Is it 2π/8 into n plus as 2π/8 into 2n 2π/8 into n, right? Plus as 2π/8 into 3 into n plus and so on. Plus 2π/8 into 7 into n. What is the period of this?
8,
right? And this is the fundamental period of this one. Fundamental period of this one is 8. I can take any linear combination of them. For example, some non-zero constants. C1, let me consider non-zero constant. C2 into this one. C3 into this one. And some C4 into this one. Some non-zero real constants. Then I am going to get fundamental period of 8 for them. Fundamental period. This is fundamental period. Because I am going for LCM of fundamental period of this one is 8. Fundamental period of this one is how much? For second case? 4, right? We got 4. And fundamental period for this one is 8. And next one is 2. And so on. The last one we got as 8. And if you found all those things, we are going to get 8. Which is equal to n. If I replace this with n, if I replace this with n, and if I replace this one with n minus 1, then I am going to get fundamental period of this one is n, right? Yeah, that's what we are claiming here. The same thing you can do for e power j 2 pi k by n, complex exponential sequence. Because they are similar, right? Cos, sine, e power j, e power minus j, the term. Here also mistake is there. This is not fundamental period. They have same period, but at least one of them is having this fundamental period n out of them, out of n minus 1. If you have a linear combination of these sequences, then that will have fundamental period of n. Similarly, if we have linear combination of these sequences, then you have fundamental. If n is fundamental period of x of n, then nk equal to kn also period of x of n. Need not be fundamental period. This will be period, right? For example, if n equal to 4 is the fundamental period, into 4 means 16 is the period, and so on, right? All of them are periods for that x of n. But fundamental period is least possible one. Can you have a look into this? What is the fundamental period of x of n equal to c? Let me have some constant sequence. X of n equal to 10, for example. Say for all n. Say 0, 1, say n. 2, 3, and so on. This side also it will repeat, minus 1, minus 2, and so on. And the height of here 1 is 10. Then what is the fundamental period of this one?
We cannot define.
Oh, here we can define. But really you can't define. See, when coming to DC, in the continuous time domain, we can't define period for this. The reason is, yeah, what is the reason for that? When coming to real, say DC 10, some x of t. X of t equals to x of t plus t. For all t belongs to real space, this is always true, right? This is always true. X of t plus t equals x of t in this case. we can't find smallest possibility. What is the smallest possibility in this case? Yeah, any guess? When coming to continuous case, there should be real number here, right? It's not integer. Need not be integer. There should be real number. What is the smallest possibility such that construct positive t1? What is the smallest possibility? Here, if you say 10^-100 is the smallest possible, what I will do is I will do divide by 10. I will get 10^-101. This is the smallest possible compared to this one, and someone can do divide by 10. That's the issue with this one. You can't define that one when coming to continuous. But when coming to discrete, you can define. What is the issue with this and discrete? You need to worry about smallest possible integer. Possible to define this? Yeah, what is n?
1, sir.
N is 1, right? In this case, fundamental period is 1. Because this smallest possible integer, you are looking for smallest possible integer. Here, you are looking for smallest positive real number, which is undefined. You can't define that, right? Here you can define. N equal to 1 for this. N equal to 1 is the fundamental period. By default, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on are periods of this one. Some integer into n, right? Nk equal to kn. Fundamental period of x of n equal to c is n equal to 1. Let's have a sequence like this. X of n equal to sigma k equal to 0 to n minus 1. Ak into e power j 2 pi by n into n. Like this. What is the fundamental period of this one? Just now we had discussed, right? The linear combination. Let's assume all of them are non-zeros. Is AK coefficient. Yeah, why the fundamental period? Linear combination of complex exponentials of this kind, 2 pi k by n, the other frequencies. K
equals
n, right? Because the fundamental period of this one is LCM of 1 comma n like this. At least one of them will be n, as we saw in last example. Some of them might be, if you do divide by some integer, or if you do multiplication with some integer, you are going to get n, some of them. Finally, you are going to end up with n. It's a fundamental period of that. N equal to 1 is the fundamental period of first one, when k equal to 0. It's a DC, right? DC component, k equal to 0, a 0, e power j 2 pi 0 by n into n. 2 by 0 means it's a 0 n, e power j 0 n. Fundamental period of that one is 1. If you apply LCM of them, you are going to get n. See, this need not be LCM of 1 comma n comma n comma and so on. This will be like LCM of 1 comma n. Because at least for the remaining part removing k equal to 0, we proved that fundamental period is n. Now, no need to worry about the remaining terms. You can have the combination k equal to 1 to n minus 1. That period is n. Then we will apply LCM of 1 comma n. LCM of 1 is n. The fundamental period of this one. And which is the basic thing that we required for DFT, discrete Fourier transform. Okay, is it true or false? Statement, some statement is given here. Omega naught and omega naught plus 2 pi r, where r is integer. These are indistinguishable frequencies when coming to digital. I have proved that omega naught and omega naught plus 2 pi k are indistinguishable frequencies. From this, we can claim that There are total capital N distinguishable frequencies for which the corresponding sequences are periodic with a period of N. You can find only capital N number of distinguishable frequencies. This is the basic for DFT. It means no need to worry about infinity. See, what I want to claim here is e power j 2 pi k by n into n. Fundamental period. Let me claim it like fundamental period of n, capital N, when all of them are non-zeros. Yeah, that's my claim. Oh, forget about AK. Yeah, let me rename this some BK. Okay, which one I can follow? See, my question is, if I want to express my signal x of n, someone giving me a periodic signal. In the continuous time case, you can find a Fourier series expansion for periodic signal, right? Let me recall that just for your convenience. Let me consider continuous time case, x of t plus t equals to x of t. It's a fundamental period of that one. Let me say this is the fundamental period. In that case, how to express this? Yeah, someone can give me that Fourier series expansion, k equal to. Minus infinity plus infinity. Like this, you can write, right? If x of t is a periodic signal with a period of t, then I can try to have Fourier series expansion as follows: x of t equals to sigma k equal to minus infinity plus infinity, a k into e power j 2 pi by t into 2 pi by t into k into small t. Like this, I can have. As a linear combination of complex exponential sequences. The reason for writing like this is of each of them is t. Is it true or false? I am claiming that the period of each of these complex exponential sequences for all k integers, this is t. True or false? E power j 2 pi k by t into t. I am saying that the period of this one is t. Is it true? Sure, you can cross check, right? You can replace t with t plus t. And the second part, e power j 2 pi k by t into t. If I multiply this into two parts, e power a plus b equal to e power a and e power b, right? T gets cancelled out. E power j 2 pi k is 1. I can say period of this is t for all k integer, for all k integer. Period of each of them is capital T. And at least one of them is having a fundamental period of t for k equal to 1. If I consider k equal to 1, for k equal to 1, this t is not only period, that is a fundamental period when k equal to 1. If I try to find linear combination of all those complex exponential sequences which follow this pattern, then I am going to get that fundamental grade will be T after doing any combination of all the things. And the fundamental grade of my signal is also T. That's what I am doing in my Fourier series analysis, right? I'm trying to represent my signal, periodic signal, as a linear combination of complex exponential sequences, complex exponential signals. Each of them is having a period of T, and at least one of them is having a period of capital T, right? In this case, the first one, for k equal to 1, is having a period of capital T, fundamental period. Same thing we are doing for discrete case also. But when coming to discrete, no need to write like minus infinity to plus infinity. It's not required. Why this is not required? Yeah, why this is not required? I can do only from 0 to n minus 1. No need to write from minus infinity to plus infinity when coming to discrete case. When this period is n, and I can write only from this to this. No need to write like this. See, the reason for this one is omega naught and omega naught plus 2 pi into integer r, where r is integer. These two are identical frequencies when coming to digital. That's the only reason I can write 0 to n minus 1 instead of minus infinity to plus infinity. If you want, I'll explain with some example. Let me consider this. Let me go with k equal to n. I'll extend little bit by 1. For k equal to 1, this will be 2 pi n by n into n, right? K equal to 1. This complex exponential. This can be written like this. Zero n into 1. Is it true or false? N gets cancelled out. E power j 2 pi n means cos 2 pi n plus j sin 2 pi n is always equals to 1 for any integer n, which is same as k equal to 0 case, right? And if I go with n plus 2 e power j 2 pi by n, k equal to n plus 2 into n. Yeah, what is the expansion? N into e power j 2 pi by n into 2n. Yeah, what is this? You can answer. What is this? What is this value? E power j 2 pi n value. E power j 2 pi n, 1, right? This for all integer n is equals to 1. It's always 1. Which is nothing but e power j 2 pi by n, where this is nothing but k equal to 2 case, right? Due to that periodicity property of original frequencies, no need to go from minus infinity to plus infinity like your continuous time Fourier series case. You can restrict only from 0 to n minus 1. That's more than enough. In this case, with a period of capital T, in the continuous time case, with a period of capital T, we are finding infinite number of signals, complex exponential signals, at 0 to infinity, k equal to 0 to infinity. Infinite number of complex exponential signals with a period of T that we are finding for this. But when coming to discrete case, you can find only n, right? K equal to 0 to n minus 1. You can find only n distinguishable complex exponential sequences with a period of n, capital N. No need to go from minus infinity to plus infinity. You can restrict only from this to this. This is a basic thing required for discrete Fourier transform. which we are going to discuss maybe after, yeah, 1 or 2 weeks. Is a periodic impulse function. This sample is repeating for every n. Can you have a look into this one? This one corresponds to delta of n. This one corresponds to delta of n minus n. Delta of small n minus capital N. This one corresponds to delta of n minus 2n, n minus 3n, delta of n minus 4n, and so on. Like this. This side, this will be delta of small n plus capital N. Like that, this will extend. The periodic impulse function with a period of capital N, right? Between, all of them are zeros in between for those integers. Okay, I'll ask a question. Let's go for shifting. Consider x of n as follows. The n. And by default, let's assume that all others are zeros. At other integers, this function is zero. It's not defined for non-integers, right? For other integers, that is zero. Answer like this. Let me have 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And then, n minus 2. Tell me. Yeah. What is y of n?
Delayed by 2 units.
Delayed by 2 units, right? Is it delayed by 2 units? Right side unit shift by 2 units. Right shift by 2 units, right? It means 0. This sample will be shifted to what?
2.
2, right? That should be shifted to 2. See, 1. And this will be shifted to 3. Delayed by 2 samples, right? Actually, that should come at n equal to 1 time index. But delayed by 2 samples means this will come after 2 samples. Plus 2 means 3. And this will be shifted to 4. And all others are zeros. Otherwise, you can follow this trick. If you want, you can try this trick also. Whatever the index we are having, equate to this one. N minus 2 equal to 0. This is just a shortcut. If you have some doubts, you can do this one. N minus 2 equal to 0 implies n equal to 2, right? It means this 0 sample shifted to 2. And let us have n minus 2 equal to 1. N minus 2 equal to 1 implies n equal to 3. This sample shifted to n equal to 3. And n minus 2 equal to 2 implies n equal to 4. This sample shifted to 4, n equal to 4. Like that, you can remember. And let me have x of n plus 2. We have n equal to x of n plus 2, where x of n is same thing. This is 3. And all others are zeros. Yes, what will be this one?
F shift y by
of n.
Or advanced
this
by
is 2. My y of n. Yeah. What is this?
Left shift by 2.
Oh, left shift by 2 units, or you can say advanced by 2 units. Earlier one is delay. This is advanced. This is this side we are shifting by 2 units. It means 0 will be shifted to minus 2. 1 will be shifted to minus 1. 2 will be shifted to 0. minus 2, the minus 1 and 0, so 3, so 2, and all of those are 0. Same thing you can do if you have doubt. Anyhow, this all thing in there, right? N plus 2 equal to 0 implies n equal to minus 2. The sample will be shifted to n equal to minus 2. And n plus 2 equals to 1 implies n equal to minus 1. This will be shifted to n equal to minus 1. It will be shifted to n equal to 0. N plus 2 equal to 2. Okay, let's go for folding operation. Zero, one, two. Let me have 1, 2, 3, and all others are zeros. See my x of n, y of n equal to x of minus n. Yes. What will be this one then?
Time reverse.
Oh, just for understanding. Let me have. Okay, it's fine. Yeah. What will be my x, y of n? After folding. Folding with respect to 0, right? Index. You need to fold with respect to this one. Otherwise, you can apply the trick only. Minus n equal to 0. Implies n equal to 0. This will be in the same location, right?
Time reversal of x.
That's fine. And minus n equal to 1. See my y of n. Minus n equal to 1 implies n equal to minus 1. This will go to minus 1 location. And minus n equal to 2 minus implies n equal to minus 2. It will go to minus 2 location. It's a folding operation. Suppose I have something here, minus 1. I have some extra. See minus 1, minus 2. Then what will happen to this one?
It goes to 1 with amplitude minus 2.
Where it will go?
It goes to 1.
It goes to 1.
With amplitude minus 2.
Minus n equal to minus 1 implies n equal to 1, right? This sample goes to 1, n equal to 1. Minus 2. It's a folding operation with respect to this one, right? You are folding this. Like that, you can visualize this one. And let me go for this. Y of n equal to x of 2n. Let me have x of n in the same manner. But this time I'll try to extend a little bit. 2. 3. And all others are zeros. And they have zeros in the remaining integer locations. Minus 1, minus 2, and so on. 5, 6, and so on. This side. Yeah. Then what will be my x of 2n?
We get a compressed version of x of n.
Okay. Yes, that's
fine. With the values at 0, 1, and 2.
The 0.
With their corresponding amplitudes 1, of 0, 2, 2, 4.
4, 5, and so on. Minus 1, minus 2, and so on. Yeah, can you just tell me what will be this one?
One.
One. It's good. It's fine. You see one. Yeah, what will be this one?
Three.
This will be three. Yes. What will be this one?
Five.
Five, right? And what will be this one?
Zero.
Zero, right? All others are zeros. Like this, we are going to get. Okay, if you have doubt, you can do the same trick. You can have 2. 2n equal to 0. 2n equal to 0 implies n equal to 0, right? This got shifted to n equal to 0. This is n equal to 0. And 2n equal to 1. This got shifted to n equal to 1 by 2. Yeah, what is this? It looks strange, right? Yeah, this got shifted to n equal to 1 by 2. What is the meaning of this? But according to our analogy, this should be undefined at fractions, right?
Yes,
this will
sir.
Be defined only at integer values of n. N should belongs to J. Fraction, right? That should be undefined. It means you won't consider this one. You won't consider this sample. Because we are getting undefined part, right? That index. 2n equal to 2. It means n equal to 1. This sample shifted to n equal to 1. There's no issue with this one. 2n equal to 3 implies n equal to 3 by 2. 3 by 2 is a fraction, right? That's not an integer. That should be undefined at that part. We can neglect this. And 2n equal to 4 implies n equal to 2. This got shifted to n equal to 2. This sample. Pi, right? And what? Are you missing any information with this? Do you lose any information? Do you lose information in this? Information loss, is it there or not? This is my information. I have sequence of samples 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And after doing this compression sort of thing, x of 2n, I ended up after doing this one. Am I missing any information?
Yes, sir.
I'm missing information, right? Because this got removed, right? This got removed, which is irreversible process, at least for now. It's irreversible, right? I can't reverse this process. Because see, I don't know whether 2 is there, whether 5 is there, whether minus 2 is there, whether minus 10 is here. I don't know anything about this, right? I can't get back to this one. It's not possible, right? I'm losing information. Okay, what about this one? Am I losing any information after this? X or minus n?
No,
get back to this one from this. I can get back to this one. I can do y of minus n. Y of minus n. If I do that one, then I'm going to get back to this. I'm not losing any information. Am I losing any information with this operation? Here also, I'm not losing any information. If I want to get back to my actual x of n, I can simply apply delay by 2 samples. I will do y of n minus 2. I'll shift this right side by 2 units. I'm going to get this one. And here am I losing any information? With this, the content, sequence of samples.
No, sir.
Here also same thing, right? I can simply go for y of n plus 2 option. In order to get this one, at least mathematically, you can say you are not losing any information, right? Up to that. But here we are losing some information. Okay, it's already 1 hour, right? Okay, ask a question like time reversal also like a time scaling property. Yes, you can treat like that one. There is no issue with this one. What we can do is time scaling means x of an, where k is some integer. Let me think like that. Or let's make go with the actual notation that we follow. Capital M into n, where m is some integer. If I go for m equal to minus 1, then m equal to minus 1, m can be some integer. That's just a subcase of that one. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, and let me go with this. Yeah, that is fine. I'll stop recording the session. Yes, someone raised the hand, right? Yeah, any.